Hey guys, what's up? This is your host Immortalknight Cubing, and I'm here with a brand new episode on this channel. This is my first ever YouTube video. I hope you all enjoy this, and of course like it, share it with your friends and also subscribe. But that's not how we're gonna start. We're gonna start with some way different. I'm actually a CFOP solver, and most of them actually, I've gone through YouTube many CFOP solvers, and the highest question that gets asked is how do I look ahead during my F2L? Well, look ahead is not such a complicated task. You can learn it very easily. And yes, if you don't know what is F2L and how to do F2L in a cube, using F2L in your normal solves, I'll be leaving some links in the description. Make sure you check them out. Or if not, if I cannot leave links in the description, you can just go ahead and search for F2L look ahead, and there'll be just a lot of videos on, and you can click anyone and just enjoy watching it. Well, this video is on how to look ahead, and some tips will be given by me on how to look ahead. Honestly, just practice is what I'm not about to say right now. Here are some of my good tips. So first of all, you need a good cube, not a cube which stacks regularly. If your budget is a little cheap, you can go ahead with the YJ Guanlong, or you can also go with some good cubes. The tip number one for solving F2L, getting good at look ahead, is actually slowing down. Now, what I mean by actually slowing down is, for example, let me just set up my quad before that. Okay, so you know, this will be a color neutral video, so you need to be color neutral and not just white cross solver. Now, what do you mean by actually look slow down and look ahead? Slow down and look ahead means that your regular TPS, if it is like 4, 5 or 6 TPS like that, you need to slow it down to around 2, 3 or 4 TPS. It's up to you, whichever you're comfortable at. The reason why this makes your solves look very good is because you will have a constant fluid, and you will know where your next pair will end up. Because since you do your solves so damn slowly, you'll have a whole track of what piece, which piece go where in the whole cube. So that is the tip number one. Actually slow down and look ahead. For example, if I see this pair and I know that this should go in here, so now I can track this piece, and in the meanwhile, when I do this, since I know that this needs to come up here itself, this corner piece will go to the top layer, and I can correspondingly simultaneously find its respective edge piece. Now to do this F2L pair, I think you know the algorithm, and I notice that the edge is here, so I can straight away just go into that as my second pair, even though I was not looking at it. So here comes the second tip number two. Look at spots where you haven't seen yet. Now what I mean by this is that when I was solving this F2L pair, I was actually tracking the whole cube and which piece goes where, and that is the reason why I knew that this piece, this edge piece, it was here, and I could directly go into that as my second pair, and I knew that the corner was here. So, and of course you know how to solve it, you just hide the corner, and then now here comes in the third tip. So okay, I guess that you understood my tips in 1 and 2 till now. You should be you should not only insert it like this from front using RUR prime. What you can instead do is, since here, imagine that you had a F2L pair done, and if you just insert, it would be no use because you didn't know that what was going on behind the cube. So what you should do is instead rotate the cube, because however, after doing this F2L pair, you will have to rotate your cube once. So if you want to rotate it itself, why don't you rotate it before and then actually insert it? So I will immediately know that this is my F2L, next F2L pair, and I can just straight away go into that. And yes, that was your tip number three, learn inserting from back slots as well. Yes, now here comes in the tip number four. So here comes in tip number four. So what is tip number four? This is one of the most important part in your look ahead. Now you need to, you should never look at the F2L pair you're doing. Now how this benefits you is because, when imagine now I just do this and I do it very fastly, oh sorry, I just scrambled it up. Okay, yeah, here it is. So I just inserted it that way, and I don't know where's the other one. So what you should instead do is, if I wasn't looking at these two and I was looking at something else. Now for example, if I told you that learn B fluid, and you can insert it from back slot. So you could have inserted that from the back slot somewhat this way. So that would benefit you, because you know that your corner piece is here, the edge piece is here, but where is the corner piece? Now that is why you need to be very conscious and not at all look at which F2L pair you're doing. If you are looking at it, you would never know that these two. But since I wasn't looking at them, the pair which I was doing, I knew immediately that these two are gonna be my fourth and final F2L pair. Now, sometimes what happens, even after you watch this video, you try to resist yourself not looking at the F2L pair you're doing, but still, you cannot resist yourself completely, and anyhow, at some F2L pair, you look at what you're doing. So, try solving the F2L pairs blindly. What I mean by this is that, my camera stand fell out. I'm sorry. Alright, so now imagine that these two are my F2L pairs. Now how to insert them, you know a very basic way. You just do it this way, hide the corner behind, bring in that edge over there, and then do it like that. Try doing this without seeing how this benefits you. Is because since you're not looking at which F2L pair you're doing since you were blind, just apply that while solving. Don't think that you're blind, just ignore that piece. And you can just be tracking on some other pieces during that F2L pair get solved. So yes guys, they are my top tips on how you can improve in your look ahead. And yes guys, that's it for this video. I hope you all enjoyed it, liked it. And yes, stay tuned for some more videos. Be sound. And also, don't forget to leave a like, share with your friends, and most importantly, subscribe. Bye.